Hi, I'm Margeaux Cronce, and I teach Family and Consumer Sciences for grades 9 through 12. So the first person that gave me the idea of being a teacher was one of my favorite high school teachers who kind of pulled me aside one day and said, I really think you should consider going into teaching yourself. The line that really stopped me was she said, it would be an injustice to all the people you could have taught. I love being a teacher. I really think it's an honor. And there are many times where I think, I get to do this? Like, really? I get to be a teacher? And now that I'm a parent and I think about the influence that teachers have on children, it still humbles me to think that I have that role in other people's children's lives. I teach 5 different classes that have varying topics. I teach a basic adulting class called Intro to Family Consumer Sciences. I also teach fashion design. I have a psychology-based class that looks at relationships, as well as 2 culinary and nutrition classes. I want my students to be talking. I want them to be social. We're doing and we're learning and we're having fun, like always. When they hit a milestone, they usually will say something and celebrate, like, oh my gosh, I just did this. Did you see this? And seeing that aha or whoa, I've never thought about that is amazing. The PA came on and it was announced that we would not be returning on Monday. And I was completely shocked. I thought, wow, this is bigger than I realized, and there's so much more about what's going on than I know. So it completely surprised me. Now, for a time, I think that there was a little bit of a honeymoon period, and then that faded, you know? And, oh man, I didn't expect to get emotional, but, sorry. But I did really miss. Oh, I really missed seeing my students. I don't think I've actually talked to anybody about this yet. But yeah, the honeymoon period faded and then it got real. And I realized I don't know when I'll see these kids again. Some of them, back when we were actually in school, said, Mrs. Cronce, I don't want there to be a school closing because I don't want to be at my home all day. And so when we went completely online, I would think of them and just worry. I worried about my students. So how did I transition from a typical brick and mortar style, teaching day to being online? And then on top of that, having no prep time. Nobody did. Families didn't. Teachers didn't. Students didn't. So how do we just go into this? It took a lot of creativity, and I tried to put myself in the student's shoes and thought, all right, if I was this student, what would get me interested? By the end of the school year, I was ready for a break, and I normally don't feel that way. But I think that it came from actually a place of empathy where I wanted my students to have a break. I was so excited for them to have a break. I had a baby in August, so I was pregnant through the whole school closing. And we had a pandemic baby. My maternity leave will be for the entire fall semester. That was the plan from the beginning. So I plan on coming back semester 2, which is in mid-January.
Things have been going really well here at home. I've got a new little baby here, and he is just a joy. He's just a reminder that life is, there's a lot to be grateful for, and that things will get better, and that there's hope and there's still good things happening.
When I found out that I won the actual award, I was incredibly honored, just so grateful. I feel like one of my biggest purposes here in life is to be a teacher. I feel like it's just in my DNA and what I was meant to do. And so when I get back into the classroom, it will feel like the puzzle pieces have kind of clicked back together. Like, oh, this is my place. This is where I'm meant to be.